Judge.
You just don't see.
Oh, you see him?
He's causing a shadow on the post.
Oh, Kai.
He's doing shadow.
Okay, maybe he should go out.
Seriously, terrific performance. I mean, it's hard to think of another actress who could play this role as well as you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Yeah, I mean, and this looks like... It's a movie that...
Sorry, maybe we should just take him out. You're going to have to... I'm just doing this, so you have to say that to me 3 times. Because it makes me feel good about myself.
Oh, okay.
It's Uncle Dave.
Your character...
I love this preparation. I want to talk to you all day because of this preparation.
Yeah.
This book is extraordinary. I need someone who can hunt and guide and spell me up the reins and help with the animals on the trip. That's why I set you free. It's your job, and you sworn to do it.
3 crazy women for 5 weeks is a lot more than I bargained for.
If you've lied to me and intend on abandoning your responsibility, then you are a man of low character. More disgusting pig than honorable man.
Thank you for the kind words, sister. You're no prize yourself. You're plain as an old tin pail and you're bossy. But I'll set out with you because I said I would. I'll help you tend your cuckoo clocks as long as it suits me. However, I will up and leave when, where, and if I please. Now, if you don't mind me asking you, where the hell is my goddamn bed?
In the stable, where you belong.
Fantastic film, really.
Honestly. Thank you.
You're welcome. It's a part of history that we've never really seen enough of in film. This is not a movie you can boil down to one sentence, which I think is great. And
thank you for that.
What appealed to you most about this story?
My friend Michael Fitzgerald sent the book to me and asked me to read it to see if I thought there was a good movie in it. I decided immediately that there was. And what makes it good is that we'd have a chance to make a screenplay that had some originality to it. And of course, our lives as filmmakers are never-ending. Search for originality.
I mean, this is one of those movies, I mean, it really transports you back to the period it takes place in really fully. There's very few movies that do it. The only other movie I can think of is Mike Leigh's Mr. Turner. And I was curious, what part of your research really informed the look of this film for you?
What part of my research?
Mm-hmm. Like photographs or...
Oh, yeah. There was an itinerant photographer who was actually moving around Nebraska territory in the mid-19th century, precisely where we had to be and wanted to be. We had a good photographic record. His name was Solomon Butcher. Mm-hmm. And he would come to your dugout or your sod house and take a picture of your family. And that was a reference after reference to architectural detail, to costumes, because these people would have the chance to get their picture taken was a very big deal for them. So the entire family would come out and stand in front of the house. And Mr. Butcher would take a wide angle shot, which would feature the entire structure and every member of the family. And if they had had a good crop of watermelons that year, they would have a table out in front with their watermelon, one of their watermelons on it, cut open. If they happened to own a piano or a melodeon, they'd bring it out of the house and get it into the photograph. And they'd stand there in their best clothes with their guns. Whatever they were proud of. One family that lived in a dugout actually put their cow up on the roof.
Oh, wow.
The milk cow. They were very proud of their milk cow. They wanted to get her in the shot. They didn't have quite enough room to put her in front, but the house is built into the side of a hill. So in the photograph, it looks as if the cow, it's kind of like Mark Chagall, the cow is up on the roof. Good, big, healthy milk cow, something for those people to be proud of. This photographic record became very important for us as reference for costumes, architecture. And it also, you felt you could read their minds by looking at their picture. We have that vanity.
My understanding, this was a very hard movie to finance, and that one of the major pieces was Luc Besson's company, Europa Corp, coming aboard.
Yeah.
To finance.
That was the first. That's what got the ball rolling. Luke is a good friend, good filmmaker. We've had a wonderful experience working with him on two different movies. And we couldn't have made this one without him. But there are other investors as well.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, they definitely were a big part of this movie's success, I think, yeah.
Well, yeah, they paid the bills.
Yeah. When it came to researching, how deep did your research go into this period the movie takes place in?
My research for this was extensive. There's a lot of different accounts that you can read about this time and in the settlers of this country. I'd say four mothers because, like you said, this movie, I believe, deals with something very different than we've seen in film before. And yet it was really also all on the page. But I come from Nebraska. My family's from Iowa. I come from a generation of farmers. So I was able to really, my dad gave me an account of our history that parallels this, I mean, to a T. I couldn't believe it. And my dad didn't know what the movie was about. So when I read it, I just thought, you know, this is a fictional movie, yet it is almost a true story in a way, because this is a true account of what we've dealt with and the resiliency of our foremothers and fathers.
And there was a point where you had to work in some harsh conditions out in New Mexico, especially with the wind.
Yes, the wind became a season. Yeah. It was like we had all four seasons in one day, and then you add the wind, and it was crazy.
Did that help add to your performance?
Definitely. I think, you know, to understand truly what these people experience day in and day out as they traverse across the state, you know, hundreds of miles by horse and a tent. And we got to get out of the elements at the end of the night, have a hot meal and a warm bed and a bath. And I think it really set the stage for why these people can lose their minds and really lose sense of any type of stability.
Yeah, I mean, even back then, you know, mental illness was a big thing.
Yes.
Yeah, and it still is.
And they didn't have the wherewithal to be able to handle that as we do now. And so they were really on their own in a lot of ways.
What's it like working with Tommy Lee Jones in the sense that he's not only directed this movie, starring in it, he co-wrote the screenplay. He has many different hats. What's it like working with a person like
that? It's so extraordinary. Someone, first of all, he's a veteran in this business. He's been doing this for so long, and he knows the ropes inside and out. And so for me to get the opportunity to collaborate with him and just learn from him and hone, you know, off of his knowledge was something that I really love as an artist. And I got to do it with Clint Eastwood as well, as someone who's the director and co-star, working so closely in that kind of symbiotic thing that you have, and working here, you're here, and it's. I didn't want it to be over. It was great in every way.
What I've heard about the financing of this movie is that a lot of it was financed by a friend of Tommy's, but a lot of it also came from overseas through Luc Besson's company, mm-hmm. Europa Corp. How difficult was it to fund this film?
Well, I think funding any film can be a challenge, but that might be more of a question for Tommy Lee, only because I wasn't a producer on this movie. But I can just say thank you to all those people for funding it so that we could get this little movie that could up and running. I think it's gives people a nice choice besides going to a big tentpole movie. It gives people a nice slice of life. And as an audience member, when I go and see movies, I like to have those options. I want to see a slice of life and maybe a comedy and the big movies. I want my choices. So it's nice that we're out there amongst those.
Heavenly Father, look down upon thy daughter. Bless her in this undertaking. Grant her thy strength. Guide her with thy grace that she may carry home these poor souls. We beg of thee. Amen.
What do they want?
Whatever we got. If they think we're worth the trouble, we're dead.
Something happens to me, you get in the wagon quick as you can. You shoot the women in the head and then shoot yourself.
Perhaps you don't realize what a grand thing you're doing, taking these poor, helpless women home. If you don't, I assure you, I do. This might be the finest, most generous act of your life.